मैडम डॉक्टर साहब बच्ची प्रेजेंटेशन स्टार्ट करने लगी है।
आई कांट लिसन,
आ रही है?
मुझे आवाज नहीं आ रही। मैडम क्यों, मैडम को आवाज नहीं आ रही? डॉक्टर शबनम प्लीज देखें क्या है।
जी सलाम अलैकुम डॉक्टर आबिदा, आप अपना स्पीकर चेक करें, बाकी सबको आवाज आ रही है।
मैडम अब आवाज आ रही है आपको?
शबनम आप अपना ना वो अनम्यूट करें, आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही। अब
मैंने अब खोला है, मैं पूछ रही थी मैडम आवाज आ रही है आपदा को?
बहुत कम है
मैडम की। मैं आ रही है मैडम को, हमारी शायद नहीं जा रही। मैडम की आ रही है?
अगर मैं
रखा ही नहीं इधर, क्या करें?
मैडम आपकी आवाज हमें आ रही। मैडम आपकी आवाज आ रही है
जी, अब आ रही है
जी मैम।
और
ठीक है मैडम,
चले नहीं, बिस्मिल्लाह करें, बिस्मिल्लाह करें, ठीक हो गया। स्टूडेंट किधर है
मैडम? स्टूडेंट बैठी हुई है, वो प्रेजेंटेशन दे रही है।
ओके जी, उसे कहें अपना इंट्रोडक्शन करवाए।
ओके मैडम।
हेलो जी, एक्सक्यूज मी, ये स्टूडेंट से कहें उनकी माइक में कोई प्रॉब्लम है, उनको काइंडली कॉल करके बताएं, उनको पता नहीं चलेगा इसे।
डॉक्टर शबनम, स्टूडेंट की आवाज नहीं आ रही, स्टूडेंट को फोन पर बताएं उसकी आवाज, स्पीकर को कोई इशू है?
स्टूडेंट की आवाज नहीं आ रही।
नहीं आ रही,
नहीं आ
मैडम, मैं अपना मोबाइल साथ रख देती हूँ, उस पे आवाज सही है, यहाँ से आ जाएगी।
स्टूडेंट को बताएं ना, उसका स्पीकर का कोई इशू होगा, वो उसको मैं भी अनम्यूट किया हो।
मैम अब आपको आ रही है आवाज?
जी बोलेंगे तो आ रही है ना।
आवाज उठी, बोलो शाबाश, पीएचडी का वाइवा।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम, आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट माय टॉपिक बायोकल्चरिंग ऑफ सम फिलामेंटस ग्रीन फ्रेश वाटर एलजी एंड देयर पोटेंशियल एप्लीकेशन एज फर्टिलाइजर। Starting with introduction, algae are heterogeneous phototrophic group of organisms that have been found widely in many natural habitats. They are major contributor to global biodiversity with the estimated number of species ranging from 36,000 to more than 10 million. Algae show several commercial applications in the field of nutrition, medicine, pharmaceutics, cosmetic waste removal, biofuel, and as fertilizer. But in Pakistan, algae are still being neglected in many fields. Recently, alkyl biomass production is attaining a great attention due to its benefit in industrial level. Therefore, it is worthwhile to isolate, taxonomically identify, and optimize the culture condition for alkyl biomass production. aims and objective of my work is to isolate, identify, and select algae suitable for biomass production, to culture algae in bulk mass, to study the influence of macro and micronutrients on algae, and to develop simple and cost-effective culture media that are economical at industrial level. And in the last, to determine the potential application of algae as fertilizer. Moving towards review of literature, following articles were studied throughout the research work, and the articles...
आवाज फिर बंद हो गई डॉक्टर शबनम स्टूडेंट की, आवाज नहीं आ रही है।
And for this, four different areas were selected, that are IV Siphon, BRB Lahore, Head Baloki, and Jallo Park. At the time of collection, the latitude and altitude of area by using GPS meter was also recorded. Then comes the screening and identification of algae. The screening identification of algae was done on taxonomical and phytological characteristics, including cell length, cell width, cell shape, chloroplast presence and absence, number of chloroplasts, presence of pyrenoids, and all. And these all characteristics were confirmed using the modern techniques, light microscopy and scanning electron microscopy. After the selection of algae, the selection of media was done. For these, six different media were used: A to Z media, A to Z soil media, Bristol media, Bristol soil media, BG111 media, and Bold basal media. These are the picture map and pictures of the site of collection of algal specimens. Then comes selection of carbon sources. For this, five different carbon sources, glucose, fructose, maltose, cellulose, and lactose were selected to study the influence of the growth rate by using these carbon sources. Then comes selection of nitrogen sources. For this, five different nitrogen sources, including ammonium sulfate, ammonium nitrate, ammonium chloride, potassium nitrate, and urea were analyzed. These all experiments were performed at standard pH of 7 and temperature of 35 degrees centigrade. Then effect of different pH range. pH ranges from 5 to 8.5, temperature ranging from 25 to 35 degrees centigrade, and light intensities of three different forms, diffuse light, fluorescent light, and luminescence light were analyzed to study the effect of these all factors on the biomass production of algae. Then comes the nutraceutical evaluation of selected algae. These include the test of ash, carbohydrate, fat, protein, moisture, and lipids. Then the phytochemical analysis of algae, qualitative phytochemical analysis of algae, including alkaloids, flavonoids, saponin, tannin, steroids, and phenol. After that, the effect of sulfur-formulated media on biomass production were used. As we are going to form the cheap media for the biomass production, so we make five different media containing the composition as given in table. Then in the last, application of algae as fertilizer. For these, four plots of 5 into 5 feet were formed, and each plot contained three rows. And first plot is fertilized by algae. The second plot is fertilized by urea. And for the plot three, manure is used as a fertilizer, and plot four is act as a control. These are the pictures of plotting area before irrigation of water and after irrigation of water. Then the result and the discussion. Total 21 algal species belonging to 8 genera and 4 families were collected. They were identified up to species level on their morphological and physiological features. They were arranged systematically according to newly proposed Chameleon classification 2001 and 2002. These are the total 21 algal species that were isolated from four different sites. The plus and negative sign indicate the presence and absence of species at that site. First one is genus Clostridium. Two species of genus Clostridium perilogum and Strigosum were isolated. These two species were different on the basis of cell length and width and the presence and absence of striated walls on the cross wall sections. These are the pictures of comparative pictures of perilogum and Strigosum. Then the genus Mycospora. Three species of Mycospora, Vitrochi, Flucosa, and Humidola were isolated. And these three species were also differentiated on the basis of cell length and width and their presence of chloroplast shape. H-shaped chloroplast is mostly present in Mycospora. That is the great characteristics of Mycospora identification. But in Mycospora, Flucosa, beaded band-like of chloroplast is present. Whereas in Tumidola, only granular perforated bead-like chains are present. Then these are the comparative pictures of three different species of Microspora. Then genus Oscillatoria, four species of Oscillatoria, Acuminata, Agridale, Jesselvensis, and Agarati. These species were differentiated on the basis of cell shape and length and the crossfall present among the end of cell. These are the pictures of species isolated. Genus Formidium, three species of genus Formidium, Anatarchidum, Bohinia, and Fragile. These species were also differentiated on the basis of crosswall. Distinctly narrow crosswalls are present, or either these crosswalls are not present. These are the light microscopic pictures of Formidium. Then genus Rhizoclonium, two species of Rhizoclonium, Fontanum, and Hieroglyphicum were isolated. These cells are different on the basis of cell wall thickness and length and width. Then genus Stegoclonium, two species of genus Stegoclonium, Stegoclonium elongatum and Stegoclonium lubrica were isolated. They are different on the basis of their thalli. Thalli are arranged alternatively or in the form of prostrate position. Cell are mostly 5 to 5.76 micrometer broad, whereas in lubrica cells are normally less in size. The genus Hydrodactyon, only one species of Hydrodactyon, Hydrodactyon reticulatum, were isolated. These cells are mainly present in the pentagonal shape as shown in the picture. And this species, Hydrodactyon reticulatum, show best result in all the growth rates. Then the genus Spirogyra, four species of Spirogyra, Spirogyra cumulus, Spirogyra australica, Borgenesis, and Versilacer. These cells were also differentiated on the basis of cell length and width. And also the main characteristic is the presence of chloroplast. Either one ton of chloroplast is present, either chloroplasts are in one or three world, or in 1 to 2 worlds. The comparative analysis pictures of Spirogyra species. Then the scanning electron microscopy of some members of algal species were done. These are the scanning electron microscopic pictures of species, algal species. The isolated species were then cultured on standard media, A to Z media, at standard pH and temperature. These species were grown and the comparative growth rate for the 45 days were analyzed. The table show only three species as highlighted in the red color, Microspora fucosa, Hydrodactyon reticulatum, and Spirogyra cumulus. Only these three species shows the growth rate. The other species never ever grow in that media and even not show a growth of even a 1 gram. Then these three species were further selected for the other further parameters like the effect of different media on Hydrodactyon reticulatum growth. The graph indicated that among all these applied media, six media, A to Z media, Bristol media, Bristol soil media, M4 media that was labeled as Bristol soil media shows the maximum growth of 18.6 gram per liter at the 24th date of culturing. Effect of different media on biomass production of Spirogyra cumulus, this showed that same result was observed that the Bristol soil media labeled as M4 media shows the maximum growth of 12.6 gram per liter at the 21st day of culturing. Then effect of carbon sourcing on Microspora fucosa. Microspora fucosa shows the maximum growth of 6.2 gram per liter and this growth rate is on 21st day of culturing. These all comparative analysis shows that among these three species, Hydrodactyon reticulatum shows the maximum growth of 18.6 gram per liter. So this species is selected for the further analysis. But the effect of different carbon sources on biomass production, like five different carbon sources, glucose, cellulose, lactose, maltose, and fructose were analyzed. The red color indicated that Hydrodactyon reticulatum shows the maximum growth of 10.3 gram at the 24th day of culturing when glucose is used as carbon source, when cellulose is used as carbon source, 4.4 gram, gram per liter growth is observed. When lactose is used as carbon source, 6.9 gram per liter of Hydrodactyon reticulatum was observed. Same as with the case of maltose, 5.3 gram per liter was observed. Then the effect of different nitrogen sources on biomass production. Same here, the hydrodectyon reticulatum shows the maximum growth rate of 4.3 gram per liter for ammonium sulfate, ammonium chloride. For ammonium chloride, 8 gram per liter was observed. For ammonium nitrate, 3.7 gram per liter was observed. Whereas for potassium nitrate, 4.3 gram per liter was observed, but the maximum growth rate was observed by urea, that is 12.5 gram per liter. Then the effect of different phosphorus and potassium sources. These indicated that among all these five sources, potassium dihydrogen phosphate gave the maximum biomass production of 8.6 gram per liter at the ninth date of culturing. These all experiments were performed at standard pH and standard temperature, and these were statistically analyzed by using Dunkel multiple range tests and Tukane multiple standards analysis. Then comes the effect of different heavy metals on biomass production of algae. The effect of heavy metals clearly indicate that having presence of heavy metal in media directly hinders the production of algal biomass. They restrict the growth rate of algae in every sample, either in case of lead, in cadmium, arsenic, cobalt, nitrate. In every perspective, the presence of heavy metal hindered or retarded the growth of algal biomass. Effect of different light intensities on biomass production. Three different sources of light, luminescence light, fluorescent light, and diffuse light were analyzed, and it was observed that fluorescent light gives the maximum biomass also for the hydrodectyon reticulatum, that is 6.8 grams per liter. The effect of different temperatures on biomass production. For this, five different temperature ranges, 20 degrees centigrade to 35 degrees centigrade, were analyzed, and it was observed that 35 degrees centigrade was found optimum temperature for the growth of algae, as maximum growth rate was observed at 35 degrees centigrade. Then comes the effect of different pH on biomass production. For this, 5 to 8.5 pH was analyzed, but it was noted that if we move toward the lowest pH in acidic media, algae showed no even a single growth rate. But in this all, the pH 7 shows the maximum growth rate of 6.5 gram per liter. After this all analysis, the nutraceutical evaluation of algae was done. For this, percentage moisture content of algal sample was analyzed using different solvents, and it was observed that among all these solvents, methanol extract of hydrodectyon reticulatum shows the maximum percentage of moisture content. And for the case of percent ash, the maximum ash content of 0.8% was shown by hydrodectyon reticulatum ethanolic extract. For the case of carbohydrate, maximum carbohydrate percentage was shown by methanolic extract of hydrodectyon reticulatum. And for protein, maximum protein percentage was observed by chloroform extract of hydrodectyon reticulatum. And in the same, for the percentage of fat, maximum growth rate of ethanol leak extract of hydrodectyon reticulatum was shown. These are the some pictures of experimental analysis performing during the lab work. Then the qualitative phytochemical activities of selected algal species. The positive and negative signs indicates the presence and absence of that phytochemical. More the positive signs, more the presence of phytochemicals in that compound. For these glycosides, alkaloids, saponin, flavonoids, tannins, terpenoid, cardioglycoside, phenobarbitanins, and anthraquinone were analyzed to study the qualitative analysis of phytochemical compounds. Then the effect of self-formulated media on biomass production. As I already mentioned, five different media, S1 media, S2 media, S3, S4, and S5, five different media were formed. And these were formed only to study the cheap to accumulate the cheap source for the selection of media. And among all these, as indicated by blue bar, S1 media shows the maximum biomass production of algae for the growth of hydrodectyon reticulatum. Then application of algae as fertilizer. First of all, before performing any experiment, the qualitative physiochemical properties of soil were analyzed to check the effect of fertilizers on the physiochemical analysis. When the experimental plot was studied, it clearly shows that there is a low value of all the percent chemical constituents as compared to when studied, plot 1 that is fertilized by urea, plot 2 that is fertilized by algae. There is a great in chemical saturation of soil when algae or any other fertilizer was used as fertilizer. These are the experimental plots. Inward, 4 plots were formed, and each plot was divided into 3 different rows. And in 3 different rows, 3 plants of Lycopersicum, Solanum lycopersicum were planted, and the effect on growth was noted every 3 days. And it was noted that the plot 1 that is fertilized by algae, where algae is used as fertilizer, shows the maximum growth of 79 centimeters of plant length. These are the some experiment pictures of outcomes of my plant. Then, after the plant length analysis, the average plant weight, average stem length, average root length, average number of leaves, average plant cover, average number of flowers, and average number of fruit from each plot was analyzed, and it was clearly observed that the plot number 1 that is fertilized by algae shows the maximum or increased growth rate in every perspective. Then the chemical composition of Solanum lycopersicum fruit was performed, and it was estimated that when the fruit that was grown in plot 1 that is fertilized by algae shows the maximum chemical constitution for all the parameters. Then comes the conclusion. Out of all the 21 species, only 3 species, Microspora plucosa, Hydrodectyon reticulatum, and Spirogyra fumescens, shows biomass production. But among all these, Hydrodectyon reticulatum shows the maximum biomass that proved out to be the best algae to use as a fertilizer. So it was noted that the use of algae as a fertilizer can positively influence all the growth rates and the plant yield. Hence, algae has potential to replace the chemical fertilizers in agriculture and could use be eco-friendly in all sorts of minerals. Future recommendation, the finding of current research are worthwhile, but they require some other amendments or studies, like evaluate a detailed biochemical analysis of species that is used as a fertilizer and explore other strains of algae with either than the Hydrodectyon reticulatum, Spirogyra or Microspora, and the chemical and microbial analysis of the species that are cultured and the enzymatic activity that are involved in the conversion of carbon sources, nitrogen sources and other phosphorus sources. These are the references used during the whole research work. And these are the outcomes of paper publications. One of my chapters is published in the Sun publication. These all, and thank you so much.
Madam, ab aap question kar sakti hain. आपको आवाज आ रही है? अच्छा डॉक्टर साहब, जब तक मैम से कांटेक्ट होता है तब तक आप क्वेश्चन कर लें।
एक्सीलेंट महवेश, आपके बड़ा अच्छा प्रेजेंटेशन भी थी और मैंने आपका थीसिस भी देखा है। दैट इज अ वंडरफुल स्टडी, स्पेशली एल्गल बायोडाइवर्सिटी। अब देखिए, हम जितने भी पाकिस्तान में बॉटनिस्ट हैं, ज्यादातर हम एंजियोस्पर्म जिम्नोस्पर्म की बात तो करते हैं, बट एल्जी, फंजाई, ब्रायोफाइट, टिडोफाइट, दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ग्रुप्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द डाइवर्सिटी। सो आई अप्रिशिएट योर वर्क। जस्ट नो कि आपने ये जो फाइटोकेमिकल एनालिसिस किए हैं, इनको आपने क्वांटिटेटिव करेक्टर स्टडी नहीं किए, जिस तरह से GCMS, NMR, FTR के थ्रू हम कोई स्ट्रक्चरल इलुस्ट्रेशन करते हैं या नावल कंपाउंड, इस तरह कोई काम आपने किया स्टडी में, या सिर्फ क्वालिटेटिव करेक्टर थे?
सर एक्चुअली ये आगे मेरा पोस्ट डॉक का है कि मैं इसके ऊपर जो है ना फिर क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस के ऊपर जो है ना अपना पोस्ट डॉक को आगे कंटिन्यू करूंगी। और वैसे ही सर काफी लेंथी हो गया था वर्क पहले ही, क्योंकि 3 कंपैरेटिव एनालिसिस 21 स्पीशीज को लेके फिर हर एक्सपेरिमेंट को लेके चलना, तो वो काफी टाइम टेकिंग काम हो गया था। लेकिन इंशाल्लाह मैं पोस्ट डॉक के आगे प्रोसीड करूंगी।
ये स्टडी बहुत यूजफुल हो जाएगी क्योंकि इसमें जिस तरह आपने कुछ एल्गल स्ट्रेन आइडेंटिफाइड किए हैं तो इसमें ना बहुत ज्यादा भी काम बाकी है, स्पेशली जो नावल कंपाउंड या फाइटोकेमिस्ट्री पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से आइडेंटिफिकेशन तो हो ही जाती है मॉर्फोलॉजिकल स्टडी या स्कैनिंग या जो भी होता है, तो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द नावल कंपाउंड फ्रॉम एल जी. अब मैडम मेरे ख्याल में आ गई तो मैडम भी क्वेश्चन करेंगी जो आपसे.
जी मैम. ओके फाइन. महवेश मुझे ये बताएं कि आपने कितनी जो है ग्रुप्स जो कलेक्शन की है उसमें कितनी फैमिली, बल्कि आपने जीनस लेवल तक की है स्पीशीज लेवल
तक की है.
अच्छा, एक इसमें क्लॉस्ट्रिडियम है सबसे पहले आपने मेंशन किया था.
जी मैम.
इसको कैसे आइडेंटिफाई किया आपने?
मैम इसकी सेल लेंथ और विड्थ के ऊपर और सेल शेप के ऊपर और द प्रेजेंस एंड एब्सेंस ऑफ क्लोरोप्लास्ट बिकॉज द सेल आर लार्जर और थिक इन द मिडल इन इलोंगेटम वेयर एज इन ल्यूब्रिका द सेल्स आर शॉर्टर फ्रॉम द मिडल साइज.
अच्छा, दिस बिलोंग्स टू क्लास क्लोरोफाइसी.
जी मैम.
किस क्लास, ये किस ग्रुप से बिलोंग करते हैं?
मैम क्लोरोफाइसी.
क्लोरोफाइसी, क्लोरोफाइसी की एक फैमिली है डेस्मेटेसी.
जी मैम.
आप जानते हैं?
मैम पढ़ाई हुई है मैंने लेकिन इस टाइम मेरे माइंड में नहीं है.
चले, वो बड़ी यूनिक है क्योंकि उसमें उसका नाम ही इसीलिए डेस्मिड्स, उसमें जितने मेंबर्स हैं वो डेस्मिड्स कहलाते हैं और डेस्मेटेसी इसीलिए उसका नाम है. मुझे एकदम याद आ गई. उसका ये होता है कि जो इंडिविजुअल है वो टू हाफ्स पे मुश्तमिल होते हैं और वन हाफ दूसरे का मिरर इमेज होता है. ठीक है, याद रहेगा. अच्छा, बड़ी अच्छी आपने, जैसे अभी डॉक्टर साहब ने मेंशन किया, मुश्ताक साहब ने, आपने वाकई बहुत अच्छा काम किया है क्योंकि ये जो एक पोर्शन है ये इग्नोर्ड है अभी तक. बड़े लॉन्ग अरसे से इस एलजी पे काम नहीं हो रहा. सारे बड़े बड़े काम करते हैं. आपने एक, अगरचे ये बहुत बड़ा ग्रुप है लेकिन इग्नोर्ड ग्रुप था, इसको जरूरत थी एक्सप्लोर करने के लिए. मुझे ये बताएं कि आपने इसको दो तरह से स्टडी की है. एक तो उसकी बायोकल्चरिंग की है, ठीक है, और आपने बड़ा अच्छा कंक्लूड किया है फ्यूचर स्टडी के लिए कि आपने एक्लिमेटाइज करके स्टैंडर्ड प्रोवाइड कर दिए कि इस पीएच पे ये होगा और इस टेम्परेचर पे ये होगा ये होगा. जहां तक बायो फर्टिलाइजर्स का आपने मेंशन, उसको जरा थोड़ा सा एक्सप्लेन करेंगे आप?
उसको पाउडर फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट किया था और वो पाउडर फॉर्म जो है ना 10 ग्राम पर प्लॉट के हिसाब से मैंने उसको ऐड किया.
प्लॉट का साइज,
ये स्टैंडर्ड
प्लॉट का साइज क्या था?
5x5 फीट का था मैम.
5x5, गुड. अच्छा, तो उसके फिर नेक्स्ट कोई पैरामीटर देखे, उसका कोई रिजल्ट, कोई ऐसा एक्सपेरिमेंट था?
जी मैम, उसके बाद मैंने पहले तो सॉइल के एनालिसिस देखे थे कि आइदर द फर्टिलाइजर अफेक्ट्स द केमिकल कंपोजिशन ऑफ सॉइल और नॉट, देन द इफेक्ट ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर ऑन द प्लांट ग्रोथ रेट, आइदर द ग्रोथ रेट इंक्रीजेस और डिक्रीजेस और द लेंथ एंड विड्थ ऑफ स्टेम and the yield of fruit, and it was concluded that the yield increased by using LG as fertilizer as well as the nutritional evaluations were increased when we use LG as a fertilizer because LG fixes maximum carbon dioxide in the soil that is used for the growth to increase the growth rate of plant.
Well done, well done. Bahut achha ji. Okay ji, meri taraf se it's okay.
Thank you so much ma'am.
लेकिन इस स्टडी को आपने डंप नहीं कर देना, इसको आगे लेके चलना है. बहुत अच्छा आपने काम किया हुआ है. जैसे अभी डॉक्टर साहब ने बताया कि इसको एक तो कमर्शलाइज कर सकती हैं आप फर्टिलाइजर बेस पे, ठीक है, और सेकेंडली जो है उसकी आप उसकी जो फाइटो केमिस्ट्री है उसकी तरफ जाएं और इसको आगे एक्सप्लोर करें.
श्योर मैम, इंशाल्लाह.
थैंक यू सो मच मैडम. थैंक यू डॉक्टर साहब. मैडम मैंने आपको और डॉक्टर साहब को इवैल्यूएशन फॉर्मा जो है वो ईमेल किया था.
मैं देख लेती हूँ, मैं बिजी थी, मैंने नहीं देखा.
मुबारक
हो आपके स्टूडेंट को भी. मुबारक.
थैंक यू सो मच मैम. मुझे इस चीज की खुशी है कि मेरे टीचर्स जो हैं वो मेरे स्टूडेंट्स का वाइवा ले रहे हैं, तो ये मेरे लिए बड़ी रिस्पेक्ट की और ऑनर की बात है मैम.
नहीं बड़ा अच्छा लगा, लेकिन ये मुझे बड़ी खुशी हुई है कि पहली दफा मेरा ख्याल है कि एलजी पे.
और बस ये ना मैडम आज वैसे ही
ऐसे ही है.
और मैडम ये कि आज हैप्पी टीचर डे भी है, तो हमारे के लिए पहली क्लास आपने यूनिवर्सिटी में, तो हैप्पी टीचर डे मैडम.
थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू जी. हाँ जी, बहुत अच्छा मौका है, बहुत अच्छा है, बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है जनाब. वो क्या कहना चाहिए, थर्ड जनरेशन में अपने स्टूडेंट्स देख के, ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रन, ग्रैंड स्टूडेंट. ठीक है,
थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू सो मच मैम. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू डॉक्टर साहब. ओके मैम, अल्लाह हाफिज़.
थैंक यू सो मच, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया.
अल्लाह हाफिज़.